We are here today at the Dutch venue of Monsanto. It's a vegetable seed company, Seminis, bought up by Monsanto a couple of years ago. We are here as civil inspectors, concerned citizens who want to reveal evidence of the hidden agenda of this company.
I found some genetically modified toxic water because of the plants that they're planting here. It seeps into the groundwater, and it's even now where I'm standing, only maybe 50 meters away from the toxic plants, I find some contaminated water.
You have to flush your mouth with alcohol after this to disinfect from the poisonous air.
We found a farmer, a strangled farmer with a strangling, killing contract, forcing him to buy seeds from Monsanto and buy the pesticides as well.
I'm from the civil inspection. Okay. This is the file.
Yes.
And in here are all the strict with all the poisonous information. For example, there's some information that in some regions in India, there are every half hour a farmer is committing suicide. There are lots of small farmers, and they want to produce, but they are very dependent on the genetically modified seeds. And Monsanto is having patents, or trying to have patents in some regions. And in order to keep up with the concurrence and to have good crops, they are told, they have to buy genetically modified seeds. And these seeds are very expensive, and there are also seeds in these who don't reproduce themselves. So every season they have to buy them again.
And hallo,
so they get in very big debts. And
is het plan om met z'n allen naar de
it happens that lots of farmers commit suicide because their debts are so big. So it's quite serious.
All thankful, grateful Monsanto, yeah?
Yeah.
Wow, so big corn,
and
I never saw it.
And we can reproduce ourselves.
Yeah.
Wow. We are free in the wild.
We don't need farmers anymore.
Yeah, I found some evidence of greenwash.
Oh yeah? What is it?
It's, well, we'll see at the... At the gate, we will reveal it. But it shows how Monsanto is working together with civil society organizations in the Netherlands to claim that their products are green and socially responsible.
Okay. What we also found was a panda from the World Wildlife Fund holding a bag of Roundup Ready soy. And this is evidence of the way environmental organization like World Wildlife Fund and also development organization Solidaridad actually cooperate with a company like Monsanto to create a sustainability, responsibility label for very poisonous cultivation of Roundup Ready soy. And this is evidence of one of the ways Monsanto greenwashes its image and makes it acceptable what they do, or try to make it acceptable. The other evidence we found was a press release from Monsanto claiming that the cultivation of their Roundup Ready crops is good for fighting climate change, because they claim that they can that their crops store more CO2 in the soil than other crops, and for this they want carbon credits to sell to polluting companies and make more profit with their crops, even without actually selling seeds, but just with buying air or selling air. Then we also found evidence of how far the influence of Monsanto reaches into governments. Also in Holland, it's known in the US that a lot of employees of Monsanto have there's this revolving door phenomena where Monsanto employees work for government institutions, and government institutions have employees that go to Monsanto, and these are employees involved in environmental safety assessments or agriculture policy making. This is also happening in the Netherlands in a more subtle way, where Monsanto is one of the companies financing, for example, agriculture research, and convincing scientists that their technologies are good, and get the help of scientists to prove the safety and social use of their products. There was evidence of that this influence even goes into the Dutch government. There was a newspaper article describing how a well-known professor from the Agriculture University in Wageningen quotes Monsanto Finance research about the benefits of GM cultivation to inform the Dutch parliament. And when the Dutch parliament members found out that they were informed with Monsanto Finance data, they were not pleased, they felt manipulated. It ended up in an official report from the government. Finally, we managed to reveal Monsanto's hidden agenda. It was hidden behind a portrait of their CEO, Hugh Grant. Basically stated that maximum profit and power are above everything for Monsanto.
And they would have preferred to work for another company. They have been telling us this in other locations. Noord in Bergsenhoek, north from Rotterdam, where they have a big location as well. And here in Enkhuizen we heard the same rumors.
That's
actually nobody really likes Monsanto.
Oh, Lord, a farmer is a man. A farmer is a man.